So I wanted to present you with a brief description, and we're going to draw in a table here, about the difference between genotypes and haplotypes and how geneticists represent a genotype and a haplotype using genetic annotation. So we have genes, and they're located at physical locations along chromosomes that we call loci. The location. And so I'll use these terms interchangeably during the semester, a gene or a locus. It means basically the same thing when we're talking about large-scale chromosome structure. A gene or a locus is located at a particular spot on a chromosome. And in this case, we're going to be focusing on annotation for a diploid organism, so an individual that has two copies of every chromosome. And so I want to define for you, again, how we distinguish the genotype and the haplotype of an organism. And we're going to look at situations where we're talking about a single gene, and where we're talking about multiple genes. And that would be multiple genes on either the same chromosome or on two or more chromosomes. So in the situation where we're looking at one chromosome, in a diploid organism, we might have a situation where an organism has a T at one spot on a chromosome, say their paternal chromosome and their maternal chromosome, there's a G. The genotype of this individual is a description of at a locus, at one position on the chromosome, what is the nature of the two nucleotides present there? And we write that as T/G. The slash is meant to indicate that everything on one side of the slash is found on one physical piece of DNA, like this top chromosome, and the content on the other side of the slash represents nucleotides that are present on a separate molecule of DNA. Now the haplotypes, so this is one chromosome, here we have situations where we have multiple chromosomes. The haplotypes are either T, the nucleotide that's present on a single molecule of DNA, and separately, this individual has a second haplotype, the haplotype that we call G, because there's a G at that location on the chromosome. So this individual only has one genotype. It's TG for this locus, and that T and the G comprises two different haplotypes. Those are the nucleotides that are found on either side of the slash here. Now, when we have multiple genes that we're talking about, let's look at the situation where there are multiple genes, two or more, on the same chromosome. So let's say we've got a C and a G here that distinguish one gene, and let's say there's a T here and an A here that distinguish yet another gene. So what would be the genotype of this individual? Well, we need to report the differences between the same gene first. So there's going to be a C and a G that differentiate these two chromosomes here, and a T and an A there. What you need to know about genotypes when you're talking about multiple genes is that you write the haplotype together first. So we have the genotype of this individual is going to be CT, one haplotype, and then slash, because that's on one piece of chromosome, GA. So this is the genotype of this individual when the two or more genes are on the same chromosome. You write the genes on one physical piece of DNA, you write their notation together, the slash that separates the two molecules of DNA, and then the other G and the A. And just like the first example, everything that's on one side of the slash, the genes that are on one physical piece of DNA, are one of the haplotypes, CT. The second haplotype that this individual has is GA. Now, finally, what if we're talking about two or more genes on two or more chromosomes? So we'll use the same example where we have a CG difference, but instead of both of the genes being on the same chromosome, they're on separate chromosomes. So here we have a second gene that can be distinguished by a single nucleotide polymorphism that's T versus A. Oh man, now what do? To write the genotype in this top panel, we want to write C/G because that's the genotype of one chromosome. We denote the fact that the next gene we're going to talk about is on a separate piece of DNA using a semicolon. So we've got genotype one is C/G. The next one is T/A. So that's a genotype that tells me there's a C on one piece of DNA and a G on the other chromosome. Then we're going to talk about a different chromosome, the semicolon. There's a T on one copy of the DNA and an A on the other. And in this case, it's more difficult to explain haplotypes because there's on this chromosome, there's a C and there's a G. That's one chromosome. And on the second chromosome, there are two different haplotypes at this gene. There's a T and there's an A. So like in this example, one gene, two chromosomes, two different haplotypes. Here there are four different chromosomes we're talking about, four different molecules of DNA. So we can report four different haplotypes.